So you open the viewing flap, and this is what you see. Reed beds on the main island across. Swans in front, Canada geese behind. Ducks here and there. And panning right into the scrape. The bun's semi-submerged because the winter rains have not yet finished coming in waves, and I think it is going to rain quite heavily late this afternoon. But anyway, I want to just sort of show this is that to a beginner, you'll see birds out in front, and they can probably look much of a muchness. But good field guide. I can talk about guides in another little clip. Right down at foreground. See that little chap there? I'll put it on the scape in a minute. That's a male shoveler. And beautiful it is. Rubbish light. It won't look beautiful like they are, but let's have a look. What you'll quickly discover is that the males are really easy to check out because they're, on the whole, all lots of lovely colours. Well, they are now anyway, but just getting ready to breed. So there you got a male shoveler on the left there, just swimming to view. Look at that chestnut, orange, bright orange legs. And that head of his will look iridescent green, dark green. So start again, let's get in focus this time. Right in the foreground, male and female, teal. Now, will this allow us to talk at the same time? We'll soon find out. As we were saying, the male, big gust. Female's in the foreground now. She's got like a chocolatey kind of cap, palish face, no strong pale markings. That'll be relevant in another video I'll do sometime. Male. Yeah, whether you pick up the vermiculation or the barring on the side, look at that yellow, creamy colour at the base, the flank, side of the tail. That creamy line, black line. Sometimes that line isn't always solid, but it is generally always there in most males, pretty much. And swimming off. Moving further down the bund, we've got four species. The teal are running around behind that cormorant. So many people are saying this is a continental cormorant. It probably is. That's another discussion. Either side of the cormorant, the cormorant is the biggest bird with the white feathers around, facing left now. They're a big fish eater. They dive underwater. And teal are running around like nutters behind. And just in front of it to the left now, that's a lapwing. And those three with the other bird that's just walked up and had to sit down. Another cormorant walking in behind the other one. The three in front with the sort of slightly rufous feathers. That's two male widgeon and a female widgeon in front of them. You can see the males have just lurted their creamy forehead. Greyish on the back. Another one with a white mark there. Distinctive. Oh, and look at that. That lovely male shoveler's just swum into view just to give us a nice comparison. And there's a male gadwall and a female gadwall. It's all going on. Not perfect light, but I wanted to show this pair of gadwall. Male on the right. Vermiculation, I said that word earlier. Gadwall, male gadwall has it as well. It looks, on first impression, quite a dull brown bird, but in great light, you see that black tail. The female is, again, to many people's untrained eyes, pretty nondescript. Isn't it just a mallard? No, it's a female gadwall. And, try and zoom it up a little bit. She has a much more orange bill than a mallard, and that stays with her all year. And greyish face. He becomes more less attractive, shall we say, when. He's in summer plumage, but this is the plumage they're in getting ready to breed, looking their best. And there we go. What a windy day we have. Okay, next. This is the female shoveler. It's so unmistakable, really, because of the bill. I mean, it's you just can't go wrong. We don't get any other shoveler species in this country. So, brown, all the ducks, generally speaking, female ducks are brown. the logic there is that if you're the one that's going to spend most of the time sitting on the eggs, you do not want to be easily seen and be a bright colour like this chap, the male. There's another male gadball swimming past. So it might be about all the ducks I can show you for the moment, but let's have a look. Goes through quite a little spectrum of colours in the sunlight, but iridescent green, blue, maybe violet in there, but doesn't often get captured in photographs. Let's see if the other one's standing in a more opportune position. You just caught a hint of it there. I'm really hoping to catch the display behaviour because it is absolutely hysterical. But today they're just quietly feeding in the wind. Oh, there's two noisy chaps. Everybody knows these birds who visit Stinton pastures. They're a common introduced species called the Egyptian duck. Noisy, aggressive, incredibly hardy. They breed. They've even had young now in February, but certainly by next month there'll be pairs swimming around with 10, 11, 12, 13 young. They very rarely keep that many. There's a pretty high mortality rate in Egyptian geese, mostly because they spend more time chasing off people that they don't like the look of, leaving their families vulnerable. So not necessarily the brightest birds.